Hey everyone, welcome back to MV Board Gaming. I'm Nick.
I'm Beck.
Today we're going to take a look at another party game for Party Week. This time it's Balderdash, or Beyond Balderdash. This is the new version. It is by Mattel Games. No designer. It's a 2-6 player game. We're going to give you our thoughts on this party game, see if you should buy it or not. We'll be back soon.
Alright, so we're going to go over how you play Balderdash. Object of this game is to move your colored pawn all the way to the finish line first, and you will get points by making up answers to these card questions. There's different categories. To fool other people, you get points for fooling other players into believing what you made up, your lie, and as well as choosing what the real answer is on the card. Everybody's gonna get their own few sheets of paper to write their answers on and put their initials and the question on there so that the person who's reading the question will know who submitted each one. And when they read them out, though, they're not going to reveal who it is that wrote the answers, because other players are going to try to guess if that's the real answer to the question. So to start off, you're going to roll a dice, the person who is reading. So let's say I got a 3 there. I would then take a card. I would look at number 3, which stands for incredible initials. There's different categories like weird words, peculiar people, incredible initials, marvelous movies, and laughable laws. So you would start off in this case with the 3. You're doing the incredible initials. So players are going to submit their answers of what they think MBAI stands for. And of course, the person reading the card is going to know that MBAI stands for the Mosquito Biting Activity Index. But players will write what they think MBAI stands for. The reader's going to read that out. For the other categories, so let's say if we did weird words, for instance, and we got a 1 on the dice, you would say, what's the definition of hum hum? Peculiar people category, you're going to say a brief sentence or two of what that person is famous for. So players would enter their submissions for who Sam Dunn Jr. is. Marvelous movies is a brief plot line or a byline that you'd find on the back of a movie explaining what this movie title, Expensive Husbands, is. And laughable laws. It says here it is in Fitchburg, Massachusetts. It's illegal for barbers too. And players would submit their answers. So in this case, it's illegal for those barbers to carry combs that are behind their ears. And you can get some really funny answers. And you're going to get points. 1 point for every player who votes for the answer that you submitted. 2 points if you got the right answer, because there's, of course, going to be a right answer read out. 3 points if nobody gets it. The reader's going to get 3 points. And 3 points to any player who writes an answer that's very similar to the real answer. So it's a lot of fun. This game can be really funny, and that is how you play Balderdash.
All right, welcome back for our review of Balderdash. Kind of a classic little party game for families, friends, however you want to play it. So I might be a little harsh on this one, I guess. I'm going to be a little buzzkill. 4.8 for me. Yeah, Vic doesn't like that. Well, I'll be honest, there's nothing really great about the game. The components are very bad. These are, you got your just pawns, it's pointless. Everything here is pointless. The cards, the only redeeming quality are the unusual laws, but you can get books that do the same thing. Nothing, it's a big box game. You can buy it at bargain bin that you can probably find it at the thrift store. I don't think it's very good. It's really gonna depend on who you play it with to make this game fun and funny. So to me, that's not a sign of a good game when I have to do all the work to make it a good game. So it can be good. You can make it good. You and your friends, your group, can always make games that aren't that good good. So for that, if you have a good group, it'll be fine. It'll work fine. It'll be laughs. For me, as a game, as a party game, it can be good. It has potential to be good in certain situations. As a game, 4.8 for me. It's just middle of the road, maybe a little bit less for me. But Vic likes it. Let's see.
Well, I have the opposite. I have 8.2. I'm on the extreme end of the spectrum here. I enjoy this game because I like the laws. And yeah, Nick is right. You can read a whole book. But it is fun too. Also, the definitions of words. Now, we've all been on Urban Dictionary, so we know that there are different words and definitions that can be funny online, and you could read things like that. But I don't know. I like the element of fooling people into guessing, writing something believable enough that somebody will really think it's true and they'll pick your answer. So that excites me. And he's right. You know, it is about who you play with. I haven't yet played with, we haven't played it that much. I don't play it every weekend or anything like that. But everyone we've played it with made it a good experience for the most part. I don't remember anything, any groups that really took away from it for us. But I can definitely see what Nick is talking about, that if you did get stuck with people that didn't make it more fun than it is, then yeah, it is about the experience of who you're playing with. He's right about the components. Certainly not something that I'm basing my score on is the components, but I just have a real laugh with it, and it gets requested. My dad loves it. He thinks it's a lot of fun. So I recommend it if you like word games and you enjoy these tricking people.
It's not unique. You know, you have games like this. We have games that do it better. Even Mobscenity I enjoyed more. Who cares who wins? Who cares? It's another game. Who cares?
Yeah.
Why is this here? We're going to track it for a little bit, and then this is just basically saying when we can finally be done. So I can finally be done when somebody hits that. Okay.
It's
I don't want to be... I am being a buzzkill. I know. It's just that I'm doing all the work. Yeah,
like a prison sentence for this guy.
Yeah, I'll play it. I'll play it, but I'll want to be done with it quicker than it is done. So,
well, let us know in the comment section below if you've ever played a game that you think the scoring's really not necessary and you just enjoy having fun with a party game that you don't even want to keep score of. Like this video and subscribe to our channel for more great party games. We're going to be letting a lot of different viewpoints this week of videos that are good for parties.
See you guys.